I'm going to talk you through our automation playbook for B2B lead gen agencies. So typically this is agencies that do cold email lead gen on a pay-per-call or retainer-based model. Maybe they have a tech fee as well as a pay-per-call thing. And you're probably using things like Smart Lead or Instantly to send emails. So here's our general Airtable setup. You can copy all this. This, by the way, this works whether you're using Airtable or Smart Suite. This will work whether you're using Make or Zapier or N8N or Python for that matter. This is a generic playbook. I'm going to show you some screenshots. So in Airtable, we generally set up these tables. So we have a clients table, which has all your client-specific configuration and onboarding information. We have a campaigns table. If you run another kind of lead gen agencies like Upwork lead generation or LinkedIn lead generation or something where maybe you're not doing a campaign necessarily. So actually this could be for LinkedIn lead gen, you know, DMs, you know, through like Insta or Twitter, etc. This is for, you know, obviously for campaign based stuff. We typically will do a generate a weekly report or a monthly report to the client depending on, you know, basically the client preference. So for you, it might be weekly or monthly. We would track calls booked. Even if you're using a purely retainer based plan for your clients, you probably want to track calls booked because if they're not getting any calls from your system, then they're going to churn really quickly. So we would typically recommend that you at least track calls booked, even if you're on the retainer model. And the production steps and production log are really a cool thing that we implement in Airtable. I'm not sure. I don't think it can be done in Trello or Google Sheets or you know, Monday or ClickUp or something. But I'm going to show you that in a second. And really the most, the kind of the heart and soul of this is our lead gen campaign playbook. So as you're generating a campaign, there's a generic playbook here, which I'll, you know, show you in a second, but a couple of questions to ask yourself before you would start any of this. Number one is, what do you get approval on before you actually start the campaign? So if you're running a cold email campaign, you probably get approval from your client on copy and lead list, maybe one or the other. Maybe you have some kind of strategy call with the clients. So we want to know at what point are the stopping points, the QA points with the client. Is approval done over email or Slack? Some of our clients use email, some use Slack. And for reports, I'm guessing you sometimes, you either would report on a weekly or monthly basis in terms of campaign performance. And of course, figure out what you want to report on with the clients. For cold email, for instance, typically our clients want to report on total email sent, the total replies, total positive replies, which is sometimes manual, sometimes automated metric, and then calls booked as well. All right, you need to ask yourself, what is the signal to either abandon a campaign early or to refresh a campaign, right? So typically, for example, our clients would either say, you know, after 2 weeks, depending on the number of leads in the campaign, or after the net new leads passes a certain percentage, or after the campaign is like 70% complete, they would do a normal audit and refresh. And if the number of book calls is zero after a certain number of leads have been sent, they would abandon early. You can, depending on whether you're using Smart Lead or Instantly, you can automate this signal. I would suggest though, when you're first starting to automate some of this stuff, that you actually don't automate the abandon and the refresh too early. You want to get used to the process and make sure that signal is an accurate signal always. So I would actually recommend that at least for the first few weeks that you don't automate this part. And then, of course, the implementation of this will depend on whether you're on a fixed retainer or you're on a pay-per-call booked model. So at the start, of course, depending on what system you're using, you probably have to figure out what is available from the APIs, and that will affect the stats that you're able to send automatically. But you want to make sure that you do that up front. So here's some ideas, right? So obviously, we do this Airtable setup, which is here, right? A lot of our clients ask to tag a campaign with the audience size, the country the audience is from, maybe some of the industry keywords, because that helps them on a macro level analyze lots and lots of campaigns at once to see if there's trends there in campaign health, which I will address later. You can, of course, auto-fetch stats from Smart Leader instantly or whatever and show them in an interface like this. This is Airtable interfaces for those curious. And you know, we would track things like calls booked week by week, and you can break it down by client if you want, and you can do all these kind of things. All right, a task pipeline, which I will show in a second how that looks. And sometimes it's a combination typically that you can do for either email or domain setup copy or the entire campaign. And then typically we would do some kind of alerts, and these are Slack alerts. You can do this with a Slack bot, and you can put in like buttons, like it's time for some feedback with this person. You can do emoji reactions like we've done here. You can do like green or red, big, like actual, like bigger buttons, depending on what your vibe is, what fits with your brand and things like that. And you can do custom emojis or your company icon here. And of course, this has all been anonymized, but you can include, of course, the email, right, and the name and the email and stuff like that for both when the call is booked and after the date of the call, which are, of course, two separate events. So you probably want to know if the prospect showed. If they didn't show at this point, typically what we would do is if the prospect didn't show, based on a button click, we would notify the inbox manager to say, hey, inbox manager, you know, go and try to re-engage this lead and get them on a follow-up call so that you actually get paid for that call, right? So those two things for call tracking are really, really nice. Sometimes for call tracking, people, they find that when they're first starting, at least, a lot of their clients are using Calendly. But over time, as your client list grows, you're probably going to find that some of your clients don't want to give you Calendly access. Some of them are using GHL or Schedule Once or Acuity or any of these other scheduling programs. So honestly, at scale, we typically revert to just a manual form that someone fills out, where there's an optional Calendly link as well. So something to keep in mind for call tracking. We just use an Airtable form plus the Calendly API. Inbox manager escalation is a really cool one. So you're going to have cases where your inbox manager doesn't know how to address a certain reply from a prospect. So what you can do, what we do, is we have a form in Airtable that the inbox manager fills in. That pings to the internal channel where you or the management or whatever can look at the response, and either you guys know how to reply, or you can hit an emoji and it'll automatically push that to the client's channel, and all your client has to do is reply to the Slack channel, right? And that message gets pushed directly to the inbox manager, and so they know how to do it. And then, of course, what happens as well is sometimes your client will forget. And so what we do as well is if it's been escalated for more than 24 hours and there's been no reply, then we ping the whole channel and say, hey guys, just as a reminder, we need this, you know, this response. So that is that. You can totally steal all these ideas. And then some of our clients, so for Smart Lead, for example, you can start a campaign and create a campaign through the API. Some of our clients really like that. Some of our clients don't. And what they prefer to do is to copy a campaign that was their last campaign they sent to just tweak the copy and tweak the name because it's already there. So it's up to you, of course. Everybody has their own preference. So that's the automations. In terms of, and this is an internal stat as well, so I'm going to just move this down here, management KPIs. And just put this here. Okay, so we have some management KPIs and some client-facing KPIs as well that you can build. So the first one is a campaign lifecycle and refresh velocity. So that's this production pipeline thing is kind of it's a way to measure the productivity of your campaign refresh cycle. So your copy process, your lead list building process, how long it takes to wait for the client for approval, things like that. So we use this internally. You can use this for landing pages or any kind of agency. But the cool thing about this is you can see easily here how much time any given, in our case, a feature has spent in certain states. So I can see what the bottlenecks are and fix those bottlenecks. So another one is a campaign or client health score. So you can do something really simple like emojis here. And so we are tracking like what's important for most of our clients is a lead per email, or sorry, a lead contacted, like email sent per call booked ratio. So in this case, like less than, I believe less than 1,000 is good. And, you know, between 1,000 and 2,000 is okay. And bad is more than 2,000 leads per email. And so the emoji reactions allow you to like very quickly sort and see who's okay and not okay. And then the numbers allow you to actually see the more minute trends. And of course, when a campaign is first starting, it's, you know, it's pending, right? So that's a metric that you can for sure steal. And then, of course, we have some client-facing KPIs. So this is either a weekly or monthly report of the email sent, the replies, the calls booked, and the positive replies. So typically, we would implement that one in Airtable as well, but not send it automatically. We would have a little box, and you can do the same thing. You have a little box where someone can type in some subjective or a qualitative statement like, you know, hey, it's Thanksgiving or it's Christmas. This is why this campaign might have done not as well as before. This kind of thing. Or like, hey, we tried a new strategy. This is why this campaign is doing really well or not doing really well. So feel free to steal that entire playbook if you want. I hope you enjoyed this. And if you have a cold email, lead gen agency, kick some butt, right? And I think that is all. Yeah, that's all for today.